Good morning, students. In the last class we had stopped at measurement of speed using tachometers. Let us continue with the same topic. The first one of today's topic will be DC tachometer generator. In this DC tachometer generator, you can see in this figure, the shaft whose speed is to be measured is coupled to the armature. The shaft whose speed is measured is to be measured is coupled to the armature, right? And then this is the DC generator arrangement. DC generator arrangement. When the moving armature is placed in the magnetic field, according to Faraday's laws of electromagnetic induction, when the flux cuts the conductor, EMF is induced. When the flux cuts the conductor, EMF is induced. So this EMF makes the current to flow in the circuit, the output circuit. So the voltage it is induced is measured by the voltmeter which is connected in the output path. The resistor connected here, the variable resistor limits the current. Now these brushes are meant for collecting the output current due to the induced voltage. The measure of the output voltage is indirectly the measure of the speed of the shaft, speed of rotation of the shaft. So this is how in the DC tachometer generator, with the help of the DC generator and the output circuit arrangement, the speed of the shaft is measured. The speed of the shaft is measured. Right. So in this you can see this is the armature. These are the brushes, variable resistor, and we have the moving coil voltmeter. The shaft is coupled to the armature. When the shaft rotates, the armature also rotates. Right. So due to this rotation, which is placed in the magnetic field between the poles north and south of the magnetic field, voltage is induced. That voltage makes the current to flow in the output circuit. So this voltage is measured using this voltmeter V. Using the voltmeter, the voltage is measured. This voltage is indirectly the measure of the speed of the shaft. We have seen DC tachometer generator. Next is AC tachometer generator. In the AC tachometer generator, we have the shaft, the rotating shaft, right? So this rotating shaft is connected to the rotor part. It is coupled to the rotor part. The rotor rotates. The stator coil, which is in the stator part, is stationary, right? So when the rotor rotates, again due to the Faraday's laws of electromagnetic induction, when the flux cuts the conductor, an EMF is induced. So this EMF is rectified by the bridge arrangement. This is the bridge arrangement. Right? This is the bridge arrangement. Right? So this bridge arrangement, is a rectifier arrangement. So this rectifies the AC voltage. So it converts the AC voltage to DC voltage. So this DC voltage is measured using the output voltmeter V. This DC voltage is measured using the output voltmeter V. The capacitor is meant to remove the unwanted ripples present in the output voltage. So it removes the unwanted voltages present in the output voltage. So this is how the AC tachometer generator measures the output voltage. So this output voltage is calibrated to measure indirectly the speed of the shaft. Let us move on to the next type of tachometer. It is called stroboscopic tachometer. Working principle of this stroboscopic tachometer is to synchronize the flashing light. With the rotation of the shaft. The flashlight is incident on the rotating body or on the rotating object. At a particular speed of the rotating object, the flashlight disappears. There is a reference mark which is put on the rotating body, and the speed of rotation of the flashlight measures the speed of rotation of that object. speed of rotation of the flashlight is indirectly the measure of speed of rotation of the rotating object. So this doesn't require any contact of the sensor with the object. There is no contact required of the sensor with the object whose rotating speed is to be measured. These tachometers, that is stroboscopic tachometers, are used in experimental work. Disadvantage of this type of stroboscopic tachometer is that whenever there is any ambient light present, so that ambient light intensity should be maintained. If the intensity of the ambient light is not maintained or the surrounding light intensity is not maintained, then it may not be that much effective. So this is a disadvantage of the stroboscopic type of tachometer. Let's move on to the measurement of acceleration. Acceleration of a moving body is measured by a sensor called as accelerometer. So what is accelerometer? Accelerometer is meant for measuring the acceleration of the moving body. Then there are types of accelerometers, various types of accelerometers, piezoelectric type and seismic type. Two types of accelerometers are piezoelectric type and seismic type. Let us see each one of these different types of accelerometers. The first one among the two types of accelerometers is piezoelectric accelerometer. So this piezoelectric accelerometer is the simplest and most commonly used type of accelerometer. It is the simplest and most commonly used type of accelerometer. First let us see its construction and then its working. In this piezoelectric accelerometer, as you can see in the figure, there is a crystal. This piezoelectric crystal is placed between the two electrodes. Piezoelectric crystal is sandwiched between the two electrodes, and above this crystal there is a mass placed. The mass is placed above the crystal, right? And this entire arrangement is fastened to the base whose acceleration we want to measure. This entire arrangement of the mass and this crystal and the spring type of arrangement is placed in a base, is placed onto the base whose acceleration we want to measure. So the output voltage is measured across the electrodes. This is about the construction of the piezoelectric type of accelerometer. What about the working? The working is as follows. When base is accelerated downwards, there is an inertial reaction force in the upward direction. Right? When the base is accelerated downward, there is a reactive force or a reaction force in the upward direction. According to Newton's second law of motion, we know that force is equal to mass into acceleration. F is equal to ma. Force is equal to mass into acceleration. But mass of the object is fixed. So force is directly proportional only to the acceleration, right? So whatever is the acceleration that you are applying onto the body, that is converted into the force, and that force is applied to this crystal, piezoelectric crystal. The function of the piezoelectric crystal is to convert the force into voltage. So this crystal, piezoelectric crystal, converts the force into voltage, output voltage. That output voltage is obtained across the electrodes. When this output voltage is measured, so we can measure easily the input acceleration that we have applied to this setup. Okay. So this is the working of the piezoelectric type of accelerometer. Its advantages are its weight is less, small size, high output impedance so that loading effect can be minimized. Can measure acceleration from small value of g to thousands of g, acceleration due to gravity, high sensitivity and high frequency response from 10 hertz to 50 kilohertz. These are the advantages. There are few disadvantages also. The disadvantages are, it is unsuitable for applications where the input frequency is less than 10 hertz. Cannot be used for frequencies less than 10 hertz. It is subjected to hysteresis errors, sensitive to temperature changes. So hysteresis error is when you are applying the input in the increasing direction and in the decreasing direction, the output should remain almost same. If there are different outputs produced due to increasing values of input applied and decreasing values of input applied, that is called as the hysteresis error. So this is subjected to hysteresis error and it is sensitive to temperature changes. Next is the second type of accelerometer, that is seismic accelerometer. In this arrangement, there is a mass, right? This mass is placed in between the spring and the damper arrangement. Okay, and that is connected to the workpiece. This arrangement is connected to the workpiece to which we are applying the acceleration. There is a mass which is connected through the spring and damper arrangement to the workpiece whose acceleration we want to measure. So when the acceleration is applied to this workpiece, there is displacement of the mass. The mass moves, it gets displaced. So this displacement of the mass is applied to the displacement transducer, which converts the displacement to output voltage, necessary output voltage. This output voltage is measured to measure indirectly the acceleration that is being applied to the workpiece, right? So this damper arrangement is meant for providing the required damping to the springing action of the mass, right? Next type of accelerometer or the vibration sensor is strain gauge acceleration or vibration sensor. It's one of the simplest arrangement, strain gauge acceleration or vibration sensor. Here the vibrations, whatever we want to measure, are applied to the strain gauges which are connected in the form of Wheatstone's bridge. So these strain gauges are connected in two arms of the Wheatstone's bridge. The vibration which we want to measure is applied to these strain gauges. So when the vibration is applied to these strain gauges, the bridge becomes unbalanced. Initially the bridge is in balanced condition. When the vibration is applied to these two strain gauges, R1 and R2, their resistance value changes and the bridge becomes unbalanced. The output voltage is measured, right? Here is the output voltage that is measured, V0. So this output voltage V0 gives the value of how much vibration is being applied to the both of these strain gauges, or how much is the acceleration that is applied to both of these strain gauges. So like this we can measure, by measuring the output voltage, how much strain or how much acceleration or how much vibration is being applied to the strain gauges, right? The function of capacitor, one more important point here is the capacitor here which is connected, it blocks DC and passes only the AC signal. We know that capacitor is a DC blocking element, so it blocks DC and passes only AC signal. The capacitor that is connected in the bridge arrangement, it blocks the DC and passes only AC signal. LVDT acceleration bar vibration sensor. In this figure, it is connected in the form of an LVDT. We have studied LVDT, linear variable differential transformer transducer, right? So that arrangement is used in this measurement of acceleration or the vibration. LVDT acceleration or vibration sensor. Here the vibrations are applied to the core of the LVDT. There is displacement of the core in upward or downward direction. When the vibration is applied to this core, there is displacement of the core in the upward or in the downward direction. So when this core gets displaced, the amount of voltage induced in both the secondary coils also changes. The amount of voltage induced in secondary coils S1 and S2 also changes, because this primary voltage is being coupled to the secondary voltages. When the core gets displaced either in upward or downward direction, both the secondary voltages will be different. So the net output voltage will be the difference between the two secondary voltages. the net output voltage will be the difference between the two secondary voltages. So this net output voltage across the two secondary coils, the net output voltage, AC output voltage or differential voltage between the two secondary coils is measured. So by measuring this output voltage, we will be able to measure how much vibration we have applied to the core of the LVDT acceleration or vibration sensor. How much vibration or acceleration is being applied to the core, proportional to that we get the output voltage. Advantage of LVDT acceleration bar vibration sensor is it is having better resolution and operation is frictionless, right? So in today's class we have gone through various topics such as DC tachometer, right? Then AC tachometer, DC tachometer, AC tachometer. Then later we saw stroboscopic tachometer, then piezoelectric tachometer, accelerometer, piezoelectric accelerometer, seismic accelerometer, okay, seismic accelerometer. Then we saw that is LVDT acceleration bar vibration sensor. Okay, so that's all for today's class. The next class we will again continue with some more acceleration measuring sensors or transducers. I hope everybody have understood. If there are any queries, send your queries to me so that I will answer to your queries. Thank you.